This is a keyboard and my current daily driver, a Logitech G915 TKL. It's certainly not perfect, but considering that I got it for half price, you know, it makes it a lot more compelling. But keyboards come in all shapes and sizes, and this batarang looking thing, this is also a keyboard. This is an ADM42. Now, full disclosure, I was sent this device for free to do a video on this. However, this is not a sponsored video, and I was not paid in any way to do this coverage. Now, I'll save my thoughts for the end, but looking at the keyboard, you're probably noticing a bit of an issue. Here's it on the website so you can see all of the keys. There is a distinct lack of keys. Like, where are the F keys? Where are the number keys? Where's the super key? How does this thing even work as a keyboard? To add to the confusion, it is Vim optimized and it says the ADM42 is crafted to enhance comfort and productivity, providing a great out-of-box experience. Its design significantly streamlines the execution of key combinations, which can be effortlessly performed. Especially valuable for developers, the keyboard is optimized for programming and modal editing. That's the other thing. You might have noticed a lot of symbols you use in programming are also not here, so how do you use it? Well, the way it works is it makes use of a fairly interesting layer system. When you buy the keyboard, it comes with this nice little card that you can like place on your desk and learn how things work, but all the documentation is also available on the wiki as well. So to make this make a lot more sense, I'm gonna show you the documentation on screen and highlight the part that I'm talking about. One thing you probably notice missing from this is things like a shift key, escape key, the space key. Those are there, and you might have guessed that they're along this bottom row here. So a lot of the keyboard makes use of mirroring of keys, so it's accessible on both the left and the right-hand side. One exception is the escape key. This is on the left-hand side of the bottom row, with the right-hand side being the comp key. Now, the comp key is something that I'm not gonna use because I am a boring English speaker. But if you use a language that has little squiggles and dots above letters or below letters, this is how you're gonna go and write those letters. Now, next to these, we have our left and our right shift key. These shifts behave in the exact same way. It's not an actual left and right shift. And then in the middle, this is our enter. But this still doesn't address all of the other missing keys, like the numbers and symbols and all that stuff. But these keys are still relevant. A lot of keys have what is known as a dual action, where holding the key and pressing the key have two different actions associated with them. This is indicated in the documentation, with the hold action being the colored section. If you hold either the escape key or the comp key, this takes you into the green layer, the numbers and symbols layer. Holding the enter key takes you into the red layer, the special keys layer, which includes things like your F keys, your media control keys, your brightness keys, page up and down, and things like that. Now, this key in the center, this is your delete key. It is also the yellow layer key, the yellow layer being the RGB control layer. Honestly, most of the time, you're probably not going to touch it. You'll set it to what you want it to be, which might be off, very possible, and then pretty much leave it at that. And if you hold both the enter key and the delete key, this takes you into the system layer. Another one you're probably not going to do anything with. If you're changing the keyboard layout, this is where you change it, but most of the rest of the stuff is for doing some firmware modification. Now, dual actions are not just for the layers. Both of our shift keys are also dual action keys, with obviously holding the key, this is our shift, and the left-hand side press is backspace, the right-hand side is space. But also, the keys along the left and the right-hand side are dual action as well. From top to bottom, super, control, alt. These are the hold actions, with tilde, tab, and zoom minus on the left-hand side, and equals, quote, and zoom plus on the right-hand side. Now, all of this probably seems weird, and as someone who's been playing around with this thing for probably like 2 or 3 weeks now, I can tell you for a fact, it is certainly very, very weird. But that doesn't mean it's impossible, and with a bit of dedicated effort, you can get used to typing on it. But especially on Linux, typing is not the only thing you do on a keyboard, and the developer knows this and has a section on the wiki specifically about window managers. Obviously, the super key is in a very weird location compared to what you're probably used to, but you can do everything that you want to do with your typical bindings. Now, some bindings are gonna feel a lot weirder than others. If you're doing something like super alt F key, that is now a 4-key combination rather than a 3-key. So if you design your key binds in a way that makes sense for this, it's not impossible to do. It's just gonna take a lot of new muscle memory. But hey, unless you're on macOS, it's not gonna require any additional setup. For whatever reason, macOS has like a keyboard identification, keyboard setup assistant thing. I don't know. I don't use macOS, but at least on Linux, it is plug and play and everything just works as you'd expect. Now, earlier I mentioned firmware, and I know there are some keyboard nerds out there who probably want to know, what is this using? Can I flash the firmware? Can I do whatever I want to it? This is a QMK-based project. Yes, you can go and reflash the firmware. Everything is available in their repository, so if you want to go and build off of what they have, you can go and do that. I am not a keyboard nerd, but the documentation seems to all be here to do everything that you want to do. On that note, in the system layer, there are some pre-configured alternative layouts, but if you have some weird layout you want to use, or the layout you have there is not supported, custom layouts can also be done. That is also all being explained in the documentation here, how to do dual function stuff, and go away. I genuinely hate chat boxes. I didn't think you saw that. It was behind my head there. There was like a chat box thing here. You can go do custom layout stuff as well. Now, were you paying attention to when I showed the green layer? This also had the arrow keys. Did you notice where the arrow keys were placed? H, J, K, and L. Again, Vim optimized. Let's talk a bit about the name and the ADM3A heritage. So if you don't know, this is the system that BuildJoy wrote Vi on. And this is the reason why H, J, K, and L are your movement keys. It's not about keeping your fingers on the home row or anything like that. This is the layout that keyboard had. Now, ignore the random rub key and the here is key. I have no idea what those do, but the arrow keys on the ADM3A were on H, J, K, and L. That's why those are the movement keys in Vi, and then Vim, and then NeoVim. It has an influential keyboard layout, the use of H, J, K, and L keys for moving the cursor, the control key was on the home row, and escape was easily accessible. In 1976, while working on the ADM3A, BuildJoy created the Vi editor. Although modal editing and Vi keys are now widely used, the benefits of the ADM3A layout have not been retained on modern computer keyboards. Therefore, one of the main objectives in designing the ADM42 is to revive all of the advantages of the original ADM3A design and provide the best experience for developers. Now, as you probably could have guessed from some of the stuff I said earlier, and just the weird shape of the keyboard, this describes itself as an ergonomic keyboard. Now, ergonomic keyboard is a very wide category that has just not really any standards for what ergonomic actually means. There are split keyboards, there are split and flat keyboards, there are distanced but still merged into a specific board, there are split keyboards that are also angled with often configurable angles. As such, there is a lot of zealotry, and I know a lot of people are very particular about what they want from an ergonomic keyboard. So this is obviously not a split keyboard. It is also a flat keyboard, so if you preferred something angled, this is not it. Also, even though the keys are like angled in a direction your hands would be placed, they're not as aggressive of an angle as you'll see on a lot of other keyboards. Also, everything is very close together. I understand that a lot of these things might turn people off, but hey, it might be exactly the kind of thing you're looking for. And whilst the shape might be weird, the standard typing position is relatively normal. This is assuming obviously QWERTY. If you're using a COMAC, it's gonna be different keys. But ASDF, JKL semicolon. Now, this is fine if you're someone who is, you know, competent at typing, but here's the problem for me. No matter how much I use this keyboard, and I've been using it for the past couple of weeks, I've been trying to get better at typing on it, my typing speed is basically what my typing speed is on a regular keyboard, but every time I use it, it just feels off. Now, granted, I don't think this is a problem with the keyboard. This is a problem with me. I don't really type with all my fingers. I am someone who is very much like pecking when I type. Maybe I'll use like two or three fingers, but using all of my fingers to type is just not what I do. And I know this is really bad typing form and I shouldn't be typing like this, but I never actually had typing classes. My typing ability is entirely self-taught. Also, even in Vim, and I know this is gonna bother a lot of people, I am a heavy mouse user. I don't use Vim commands to do everything. I will highlight things with my mouse. I'll click around the document with my mouse. And I know this is not the correct way to use Vim, the correct way to use Vim. But for me, this is what works. And I like my workflow, and trying to swap to something else, just no matter how much I try to do it, it just feels less efficient. However, I want to be very clear, this is not an indictment on the keyboard itself. The keyboard is very well built, and for somebody who actually, you know, knows how to type properly, I have a feeling this might be something that actually is worth checking out. With that being said, this is a fairly low production device. It is a fairly specialized device. It is a fairly niche device. All of this is to say that it has a price tag to match. It is $279. That's not Australian dollars, by the way. That is US dollars. This is a very expensive keyboard, and there are a lot of other cheaper ergonomic keyboards out there that, if you're interested in ergonomic keyboards, might be worth looking into first. But if what I've shown you sounds interesting, if this seems like something that actually makes sense to you, I do think it's built in a way that matches that price, but I can understand why trying it for that might be difficult. However, I am not the only person that has looked at this keyboard, and if you want to see the take of someone who, you know, actually does use ergonomic keyboards in a fairly regular basis, I think he daily drives one, about 8 months ago, DistroTube also did a video on this keyboard. Be sure to go check his video out as well, and see if you get a different take about it. I was very curious about this keyboard because I just haven't used an ergonomic keyboard before, and this seemed like the perfect opportunity to do so. But it's clear after using this, I am not the target audience for this device. That doesn't mean it's bad, it's just not for me. So let me know your thoughts down below. What sort of keyboard do you use? Do you use a TKL keyboard like me? Do you use a full-size keyboard? Do you use some like 45%, or maybe you use something like this, or maybe another ergonomic keyboard? I would like to know. So if you liked the video, go like the video. And if you really liked the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, Scribesly, BearPay link in the description down below. That's going to be it for me, and keyboards are neat. Yeah, that's it. What is this?